Let's go fishing.
Let's go fishing.
I'm on a mission.
I'm on a mission.
It's so pretty, I'd sure hate to waste this chance. We'll find a shady little spot, not too cool, not too high. Perfect for a little fishing and romance. Oh yes.
You got one on back here again. I seen something. No, that's a gar. I'm sorry. That's, see that gar come out?
Them things are a pain in the rear end this time of year.
Got one?
Right, took a jerk, but
took a jerk, but then that
I tell you, that gar struck at it. You know what I'm saying?
We were fishing on Toho, and she said, I don't see no alligators, I don't catch no alligators. She caught a gar, yeah.
One of them alligator gars?
Yeah, you got something good.
Just start reeling in real slow. Pull it right straight in the air. Yep. There you go. Fish on, Dawn's got a fish.
Yeah, and she said, I don't see no catch no alligators. And it was, he's a Bass Pro guy, Skip Campbell.
Yeah.
And we caught one, or she hooked one. She handed him the rod like, I don't want it.
He said, it's a gar. All right, Don, just pick it up now, Don, right now. Pick it up.
Uh-oh,
you got the other one.
That's all right.
That's going to happen.
He almost went over, didn't he?
Slipped a little sucker, ain't he?
Uh-huh.
See how he goes into that slot right there?
That means illegal.
That's a good one.
All right.
He goes in the pot.
All right. Are you going to be able to clean them for us today,
yes,
sir?
Yes, sir. I'll clean them and package
good,
them
then.
For you.
Yep. Thank you.
Yeah. Okay, you don't want to go out. A lot of guys won't do it, but I tell them, some of the students are, well, you don't want to go down here and go out here and make home clean fish.
No, that's right.
Yeah. See what I'm saying?
I could, but
I
prefer.
Yeah.
When we go down to the Keys, man, we take a couple of trips with a guy we got down there, and we load up on snapper and sometimes grouper, man, sometimes cobia, whatever.
What do you like the best to eat, though?
Snapper. I like pompano too.
Yeah.
I like snapper better than pompano.
Now, at home, we like rockfish.
I know it's kind of hard with them long rods. Measures, dude.
I turned around. I'm like, holy moly.
There's some big ones right here if we can get them to hit.
Fish on.
Fish on?
Fish on.
Good deal.
He's on fire now. At least I got the first today. I might not get the most. That's a baby.
That's a little guy there. That's all right.
Sure, curious.
Yeah, just throw him back, man.
Yep.
That's next year or the year after.
Uh-huh.
We've got a unique situation here, guys. We got this whole thing out of ourselves.
That's very
nice.
That
doesn't happen very often. Not down here.
Yeah, when we were out last year, we went out of that park back down there on the right-hand side, closer to
where we were.
Yeah. And we went out bass fishing, but
did you catch any?
Yeah, we caught a few.
Yeah.
But them fish on.
Fish on.
Fish on. So we just come in and make score.
Look like pretty good size.
Why
I'm just straightened up here. Let me see what size this guy is.
Yep, 9.5. He was close. 9.5. Mouth on it.
Fish on.
Fish on.
That's pretty good.
You know when you got the right bait on, I'll show you. There's swallow on it.
Oh, yeah.
Here, go on, give this pole a straight pole there.
No! No!
Okay!
You make it?
Yes, sir.
It's something you need to know. I always catch the most fish.
Who's counting now, huh?
What's that?
I said, who's counting now?
Oh, I do.
You know, it don't bother me.
We go fishing a lot with, we have
a friend of ours.
A friend of ours.
Competition.
He's like my he's like my big brother, but his name is Brian as well. But I always, and it aggravates him so bad that I
get. Oh yeah, it's competition. I see it every day out here. Even two guys.
How many you got now?
You say, yeah. How many you got now?
Yeah.
I don't worry about it.
That's just fun. That's the whole thing about it. I had a guy last week here. He's with his son, and his son was just wearing him out. He was just, I mean, he was just one after another. Finally, he came in and he said, change this bait. His dad did. Okay, I'll change it. I put another bait with the same exact bait, and his son caught one. I said, see?
That was a good one.
I'll keep her out of the water, Brian, for you.
All right.
How am I doing?
Good job, bud. Keep them tangled.
All right. Let me see. Okay, hold still right here. Let loose the line a little bit so I can pull this up towards you. All right, now, grip it back again. Let's see if I get here.
I figured this way he comes off and is in the boat.
Yeah. Right, let me get this fish off here real quick. Looks like a drunk one out there. All right, there you go, Brian. Yep. Get back out there. I'll keep her in as long as I can. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What's going on? I don't fool with it. I'll show you what I do. I don't, because it's real small line. You just, by the time you kind of fool around with it a little bit, you can just kind of cut it, retie it, and be back in the game. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
About as quick. Speed up a little bit. So your line gets back out there. There we go. All right.
How far did you want to go out?
That's good, right there. Well, you know, it don't really matter. Just as long as it's way back here a little ways, you know. When they had these government shutdowns and stuff, did that affect you guys' pay and stuff?
No, never did.
Yeah.
Sometimes we had to work without getting a paycheck, but then they pay us when they
get caught up, right?
Yeah. Now we don't have to worry about that.
Yeah.
A little short, huh?
Nope. He makes.
Oh, did?
Yeah, he makes. Yeah, he makes. Good.
You ever go over near Crystal River and do any fishing over there on the Gulf side?
On the what?
On the Gulf side.
No, no. I don't hardly leave Okeechobee.
Is that right?
Before I moved down here, I used to, when I take people out, I'd have to drive an hour and a half to take them to the lakes, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Then I'd have to drive it. Then I'd take them fishing all day. Then I'd have to drive an hour and a half back.
Uh-huh.
So I made up my mind that that's about the limit where we went this morning, you know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Down here, where we drove down here.
Yeah.
You know, I'm not going to do a lot of driving around. And I'm too old. I'd like to. I'm just too old. Now, if I was a young man down here, I'd have me a center console.
Uh-huh.
I'd be doing the intercoastal. I probably wouldn't be going out in the deep water, but I'd be doing the intercoastal thing.
Yeah.
Taking people in the intercoastal fishing.
When we go over to, that's one of the things I want to do over there by Canaveral, do that, what they call that, Mosquito Lagoon back there?
Yeah.
I want to do that one time. But Crystal River, we did that where we went scalloping and then red fishing.
Really?
Oh, yeah, that was awesome.
Good time.
Back behind us there.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was a good time.
Yeah,
that
was fun.
Oh my God, we caught so many redfish, man.
To your arm, yeah.
My wrist hurt.
Oh, yeah. And then our buddy, he couldn't catch a goddamn redfish.
So then we gave him
our rods. I gave him our spots. He still couldn't catch shit.
That's where he gets mad. I gave him my fishing spot. Gave him my rod.
I've done that trout fishing.
Yeah.
Like I said.
Yeah, it was funny, man. We were feeling bad for him.
Well, my wrist started really bothering me.
Yeah.
I've got carpal tunnel and stuff, and I've had operations on my wrist, so my wrist really started hurting. It did, yeah.
It did. I was thinking about, on my right hand, I have it.
Yeah.
I was thinking about getting that done, because I went in, I had plates put in my neck.
Yeah.
A year ago, September, and they went there and they checked me with electrodes, you know, what nerves and this and that.
Yes.
And when they checked my arm, they said, hey man, you got the carpal tunnel going on in your right hand, because I was dropping stuff.
Yep.
I'm thinking. Then I talked to some people, say, it worked a little bit, then don't
work. Oh, it worked for me.
Did it?
Yeah, it worked for me. Now, mind you, I was in my 20s when I had it done.
Yeah.
But yeah, they were.
And so you haven't had no trouble since?
Nope.
Yeah, every once in a while.
I was just going to say, yeah, every once in a while. Like I said, really it does get sore. It's like yeah. It will clear up a little bit.
Yeah.
But it's lasted a long time. They usually say once you have it done,
yeah,
you'll probably need to get it done again.
But you haven't.
But I haven't had to have it done again, but my index finger does get numb at times.
Yeah.
Get it up on plane and get around.
Ah, he's being a stinker. He's messing up our fishing, plus he's plowing. One thing about it down here, you run into a lot of jerks down here.
Mm-hmm.
On the water, you know. You're on the highway, but they're on this water too. Yeah, from all over the country, huh?
From all over,
yep.
I cannot believe how many people were in that campground. How many people from
Ontario? You guys in a KOA?
Yes.
Okay.
There's so many people.
Is it a nice campground?
It's pretty nice, yeah. It could use a little work here and there, yeah. But yeah, they're starting to do some more work.
Do they have events like that once in a while in there for you and stuff?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they have all kinds of stuff in there.
$1,500 a month, eh?
I don't know what it is. We've never stayed a month.
Yeah, $1,500 a month. I had a buddy of mine who was he's staying up Taylor Creek somewhere. He was wanting to come back down there, and I said, $1,500, $2,000 a month. I said, you just well stay where you're at, because I think it's that down at KOA. He's working down here. And his job's paying for it, but...
I mean, it's all right in there. It's not spectacular enough, but it's all
yeah,
right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This second year in a row we've stayed there.
Just stay a year, a month, or a week?
We just stayed about a week.
Yeah.